one more quick one, and then we'll let you guys go. The next one says, it's number written as number 40, but it says, an 0.4 kilogram object is swung in a circular path on a string half a meter long. If its speed is 4 meters per second at the top of the circle, what is the tension in the string there? Okay, so here's some mass M, and that mass has a mass of 0.4 kilograms, we said. And the length of this rope here is equal to string, it says, 0.5 meters. And it says the velocity is 4 meters per second. Okay, so it wants to know, the question is, what is the tension in the string? How do we solve this? Free body diagram. All right. Hint, basically every problem for chapter 6, it's going to require a free body diagram. So if you're not doing one, you're probably not doing it right. Just, you know, FYI. This is going to extend the exam too. If you sniff a chapter 6 problem, or even a chapter 5 problem, it's probably going to need a free body diagram. You should probably have one. Okay, forces on here are gravity and tension. And once again, because it's in simple circular motion here, we know that the sum of forces on it from Newton's second law must be equal to ma, which we know must be equal to mv squared over r. So mv squared over r must be equal to tension plus... let's see, what is that, tension plus or minus? The net must be tension minus mg, right? Because the mg is part is, let me think about this. If the tension were zero, these would need to be equal. So this must be a plus, tension plus mg. Oh, that's why I did it. That's why it's not coming out right. Duh. Okay. The tension is, of course, pulling the same direction because it's at the top of its arc. No wonder I couldn't figure it out. Okay. Duh. All right. So the tension and the gravity are going in the same direction. The sum of those must be equal to mv squared over r. We wanted to find out the tension. That's what it's asking. So let's go ahead and just solve for that there. That's equal to the same thing we had in the last problem. V squared over r plus g all times m. Let's do the same thing we did last time and go ahead and calculate that. V is going to be 4. M, or the length, R in this case is 0.5 meters. Plus 9.81 meters per second squared. That's going to be 16 times 2, this could be 32 meters per second. Wow, that is a lot. That thing is booking around there. Okay, so 0.4 kilograms times 32 plus 9.81 is going to be 41.8. meters per second squared times 0.4 is going to be what? 17-ish newtons. Kilograms, meters per second squared, it's going to be 17 newtons or so. This thing isn't very massive, but it is really going fast. So the net force is going to be equal to total acceleration, which I think is 42, times 0.4. Okay, so you got your usual daily homework, and we'll be back in class, obviously, as usual, in JEB 104 on Monday at 10:30, and I look forward to seeing you all then. Thanks for watching, and so long for now.